Hello and welcome to Pixarize the Scene on Pompe disease. In this image, we'll quickly review the pathology and clinical findings of this glycogen storage disorder, so you'll be sure to pick the right answer on your exams. I hope you like time travel, because we're going back to the past for this one. Since we're talking about Pompe disease, our scene takes place inside the ancient town of Pompe. See that volcano out back? For the history buffs out there, this is Mount Vesuvius, the ancient volcano that erupted and buried Pompeii under piles of ash. But what the history books don't tell you is the hidden story of Pompeii's final moments, where sacrifices were offered to the gods in a futile attempt to save the town. Nor do they mention Pompeii's world-famous lemon-infused malt liquor. So here we go, into the secret story of Pompeii's past. First, take a look at these wooden carts on the right. At Pixarize, autosomal recessive inheritance is symbolized by small vehicles like you see here, while autosomal dominant inheritance is represented by large, dominant vehicles like trucks and tanks. Going along with this ancient setting, these small wooden carts should help you remember that Pompe disease is inherited in an autosomal recessive pattern. Next, notice these sacks of sugar in front of the carts. I guess sugar merchants left these behind after running from the eruption. Sugar sacks are Pixarize's recurring symbol for glycogen. These sacks store sugar for later use, similar to how glycogen stores glucose for later use by the body. These sacks of sugar are here to help you remember that Pompe disease is a glycogen storage disorder, which means that it results from a problem in breaking down glycogen to glucose. So we know that Pompe disease is a defect in glycogen breakdown, but what specifically causes this problem? Take a look at this bottle of Pompeii's world-famous malt liquor, served with a slice of lemon. Even the ancient Romans knew that malt liquor is better with a splash of acid. This lemon acid malt liquor is here to help you remember the enzyme, acid maltase. But notice how this bottle is broken. Nearly all of the acid malt liquor, or acid maltase, has been lost. This is because Pompe disease results from a deficiency of acid maltase. Acid maltase, also known as alpha-1,4-glucosidase, normally works within lysosomes to break down glycogen into glucose. The deficiency of acid maltase in Pompe disease causes problems in glycogen breakdown, and this glycogen eventually builds up in lysosomes. To help you remember that glycogen builds up in the lysosome, we've also drawn an ice bucket here, which is our recurring symbol for lysosomes, or isosomes. So now that you know the pathological cause of the disease, let's switch gears and focus on the clinical findings. Let's move our gaze towards the main altar, where a sacrifice is taking place to appease the gods. First, take a look at this giant heart being offered to the gods by our priest. This giant heart is here to help you remember the cardiomegaly and hypertrophic cardiomyopathy that occurs in Pompe disease. The buildup in glycogen in lysosomes causes their eventual rupture, which in turn causes death of cardiac muscle cells and fibrosis, leading to compensatory hypertrophy or growth of the heart muscle. This is a classic finding you should know for your exams. Just picture this priest here offering our giant heart, and you'll be sure to never forget this fact. Next, take a look at this priest below. Notice how the priest is out of breath and is huffing and puffing as he lifts the giant heart on the altar. I mean, that heart is huge. It probably weighs a ton. This gasping for breath should help you remember the exercise intolerance and respiratory difficulty seen in Pompe disease, which often occurs as a result of heart failure. Afterwards, let's take a look at this Roman soldier who is in charge of guarding the altar. This soldier is also huffing and puffing, again to help you remember exercise intolerance. But more importantly, take a look at this soldier's armor. Notice how the shoulder pads and hip girdle are broken. You could even say that his armor is weak around the limbs and the girdle, which should help you remember the limb and girdle weakness that occurs in Pompe disease. This occurs because glycogen accumulates in the lysosomes of skeletal muscle, leading to eventual skeletal myopathy and weakness. This weakness presents as floppy baby syndrome and decreased muscle tone in children. Finally, let's return to our lysosome icebox, which was used to keep our heart fresh. How did that heart even fit in there? Anyways, notice how the red blood from the heart has made the ice pink. On biopsy of patients with Pompe disease, the glycogen buildup in lysosomes can be visualized using the periodic acid shift stain, or PAS stain. This appears under the microscope as bright pink material inside the lysosomes of cells. Just remember our ice box with its pink staining, and you'll remember this fact. And that's it for Pompe disease. Just picture our ancient town, our heart sacrifice, and our bottle of malt liquor, and you'll be set for any question you might get on this disease. We'll see you next time.
Thanks for watching. For more videos like these, click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can also check out the interactive version of this image at pixarize.com by following the link in the description. If you like what we're doing, share with your friends on social media, and we'll keep making great content like this. We'll see you next time.